Hello YouTubers, welcome to another my YouTube video. Today's video is all about showing you how I've upgraded my slot setup. I have now a 200 amp hour deep cycle battery, and I'm gonna be showing you how I hook it up to my inverter and charge controller and solar panel. As you can see, this is a very massive battery. And it is very massive indeed. All right, 12 volts, 200 amp hour. My tape across it, you can see this is more than 1 foot. It's massive indeed. I have added 250 watts to my 130 watt panel. But in this installation, I'm going to be making use of only one 250 watt solar panel. Alright, it's time to hook up the wires to the charge controller. Right now, I'm looking for the positive side of the battery on the charge controller. And here is it. Tighten it firmly. Alright. Now it's time to connect the negative terminal of the battery on the charge controller. Just feel like lifting this inverter for proper ventilation. Now I want to hook up the inverter, the charge controller and the battery. So I pick up the positive end of the inverter and I'm going to hook up to the positive end of the battery. You can see positive red or plus red and the minus negative. Plus minus. So the red is usually positive, while black is negative. Now, pick my charge controller, locating the positive side. So I trace the positive side and the I join it to the positive connection. So what I have here now is positive terminal of the battery coming from the charge controller, positive side coming from the inverter, all going to the positive side of the battery. So everything positive. Yeah, that's simple. Everything positive. I don't want a loose connection. I want a firm connection. Alright. Now it's time to hook up the negative terminal. Now for my charge controller, locate the negative terminal of the battery and join it with the negative terminal of the battery and also the negative side on the inverter. So everything negative. So it's as simple. I have three components here: inverter, charge controller, and the battery. Put all the positive together and put all the negative together, and you are good to go. And that's it. I should have the voltage of my battery now. It's time to hook up the solar panels. Sorry, I have just one solar panel outside. So this mark here shows me this is the positive terminal of my solar panel. I'm using one 250 watt solar panel. So on my charge controller, I'm going to look for the solar panel icon and locate the positive. There is where I'm going to hook up the positive terminal of the solar panel. As simple as that. Now I take the positive and also locate the positive terminal on the charge controller. Like I always said, I need a firm connection. And here is my system set. Battery voltage is now 12.2. And there's something blinking there showing you that the solar panel is charging the battery. So here is the remote and the extension cable for the inverter. Most inverters don't come with this, but there should be a switch somewhere on the inverter for switching on and off of the inverter. So if your inverter doesn't come with a remote control, never mind, just use the switch somewhere on the inverter. So one end is on the remote, the other end of the cable will go to the inverter. Okay, now here is the supply to my shed. So I'm going to plug this and this is going to distribute the electricity in my shed. So everything is complete. You can see it takes less than 8 minutes to set this up. And here is it. We have electricity in the shed. So right now, let's see what we can power from this electricity from 250 watts solar panel. So first of all, I go with the lights and that's it. Now secondly, I'm gonna try the ceiling fan. And there is, so I have my ceiling fan, my electric bulb on at the moment. I would like to add some gadgets to this. And here is my laptop. So I'm gonna connect the adapter on my laptop and charge from solar. and watch the battery of the laptop. It's not charging at the moment. And there it is. It's now charging. So I have the laptop, the ceiling fan, and the electric bulb. When I pull it out, it stops to charge. I get it back in, it begins to charge. Alright, I have a subwoofer here. I would like to turn this on as well. This is the audio cable. I'm gonna plug this to the 3.5 millimeter jack on my laptop. Okay, so can I play a song now? Okay, yeah. Can I actually play a song? An audio, is it? Here we are.